Yep. Terra, that's true. Everything you guys have will need to be changed to fit 60 hertz. Alright. Cutscene time.
Ragnarok. Come, day of wrath, O pulse the sea. Embrace thy fate, thine home to burn, that fallen souls might bear our plea. To hasten the divine's return. O piteous wanderer, Ragnarok. Make of this day a brave epoch. Deliver the divine, Ragnarok.
What?
Sarah, how did you...
I was waiting. You to open your eyes. All the time I was asleep, I knew what was happening. I kept trying to think up a way to save Cocoon. Together.
Sarah?
You get it now. No gods with miracles to save us. No matter where you look. That's why we have to call one. Destroy Orphan. We'll save the world.
Stop it!
You can't do that. You love me too much. You do, don't you, Claire?
Enough already! Listen up. We are all shooting for the same goal here.
And the result of that...
We know her name now.
This.
You son of a...
You betray your foul sea to chase after dreams and shadows. The world you claim to wish to protect now faces the end of days, with no hope of salvation.
I didn't think Falci had the means.
Oh, it won't be Falci who destroy her. For centuries now, Cocoon has provided generously for its human inhabitants every want and need. Coddled them, one might even say. The result being... their deep-seated fear and hatred of change and all things alien. Fed, nurtured, and ready to detonate at the slightest spark. The seeds of destruction take root, even now.
What did you do to Cocoon?
I resigned, appointing Reigns as Primarch in my stead.
Reigns? He's alive?
Puppet is restrung to serve my needs. Yes, its eyes had long since turned to glass. Of course, the cavalry's eyes will see our friend as nothing more than a traitor to their cause. They'll say the Falci got to him too, or some such drivel. And imagine when I spread word that it's Orphan tugging at his strings. What happens next?
You're gonna use the cavalry to take the thing out?
Perhaps. Or perhaps I'll feign the howling of Pulsian wolves and let the fear-addled sheep slaughter themselves first. Either way, the end is at hand. But what of yourselves? Will you enjoy the festivities beside me? Or perhaps... greet the end here, in the land where it all began.
We're not your damn dog! Vartendalus! Appreciate it. Thanks.
Well, he's an upgraded version of the same butthole he was.
Yeah.
This is the battle that I was complaining about.
What were your complaints?
He kept killing me.
This is mission 55?
No.
No.
I remember before I went back and did missions.
Oh, this is as far as you got? You got a good ways, dude. Come on, Claire. I mean, Lightning.
I'm fighting a Jabberwocky and a Bandersnatch.
Nice. Uh-oh. 5-star that booyah.
To save a people beyond salvation, there is only Ragnarok. Cocoon suffers. Release her from the pain.
So, this is the end of the rainbow, huh? Well, here's hoping the pot's full of tips on dealing with Crackpot Falsi.
You know, I don't remember this being here before. I guess it's new, huh?
Yeah, must be. I suppose it might be a record of what happened. You know, after we turned to crystal. Cocoon, where the slaves of Lindsay dwell, is the enemy of all life fostered by Pulse's sacred hand. So Al-Falsi determined Pulse's will, chose Lissi, and gave them a focus. Become Ragnarok and bring about the end of Cocoon. And so the beast arose, defeated Lindsay's hateful Falsi, and prepared to tear Cocoon apart. But her providence betrayed Alice, draining Ragnarok of strength. Their focus only half complete, the Lissi were taken to the enemy's land by Bartandalus, curse his name. And the goddess said, Lissi who rest upon Cocoon will reawaken, however long they may wait. And Ragnarok will rise again to tear the land from its seat in the sky. Her word is absolute.
Guess the jig is up.
Cocoon's done for, isn't it?
Yeah, you don't sweat it. If we go ahead and smash Cocoon, you know some makers sure to roll up and save the day.
As long as Falsi are around, this fight is never gonna end. So let's finish it. Let's get Daisley.
So what do we do about Orphan?
We help Orphan. What else can we do? If we can manage to keep it safe,
another war breaks out somewhere down the road. We're Lissi. It's not like we can make people stop fighting.
Lightning, you told me on Cocoon. It's not a question of can or can't. We just do it. That's our only choice this time. Maybe it won't do much. Maybe only one person will listen to us. But even then, isn't trying better than doing nothing?
Because ripples can make waves!
Okay, kids have gone crazy.
Revolutionaries always get cold crazy.
When I was on Cocoon,
I wished on those fireworks. I wished to not let anything happen to Cocoon this time. But I shouldn't have wished for that. Wishes aren't enough. Prayers either. This time I'm making a promise. I will keep Cocoon safe. I promise, no matter what.
I guess it takes losing everything to make you see how much you have to fight for.
And we're the only ones who can do it, right?
Right.
Yep.
All right then. Let's tie up loose ends.
Okay. Right.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna stop here for the night, ladies and gentlemen. I think it's a good place. And we'll pick up again, like maybe tomorrow.
It's an excellent place to stop.
What we're gonna do is we're going to try to become frustrated, so we'll probably play tomorrow night for 10 hours and not get any accomplishments. But if I'm lucky, we will kill the boss from Mission 55. We can move on. That's all I'm gonna tell you guys. We'll do Mission 55 tomorrow, which is one that Dredd pulled his hair out over and nearly quit life.
You. Yeah, I've spent, what, 3.5 hours total?
On 55?
Yeah, you'll start prepared and I will because you've read the guide.
We'll see. Alright guys, Kurt, stay safe. Catch you later, man. We'll see you tomorrow. You guys have a great evening and take care.
See ya. Have a good one, guys.